Adobe Creative Cloud plugins and integrations.
This is Clockwork, a plugin for Photoshop that makes it super easy to create gears, but also other circular shapes such as flowers or tires. Just for comparison, let's have a look at how you would create something like this without the plugin. So I will create a copy here, move the transformation point to the center, and with a complicated shortcut, I can now repeat this transformation. But this might not always line up perfectly, and if you want to create some adjustments for the shape, then this can become quite fiddly and frustrating. So I have created a plugin for this. Simply by clicking the path button, it already creates a path in the shape of a gear. And there are a bunch of settings here, which you can also save as a preset, just like in my other plugins. And there are many settings, so I'll go over them quickly. Let's start with size and position. Of course, you can control the radius. Also the size distribution. So we have some teeth here and the roots between them. And at the start, by the way, if you click on the label, it will reset to the default. Maybe you know this from Lightroom. It will show equal here at the start, and dragging this to the left will show only the root, and dragging it to the right will show only the teeth. You can also control the center point or move it back to the document center. Now let's go to the teeth controls. You can control the amount, the extrusion. By the way, as you can see, right as I drag the slider, everything gets updated in real time, which is pretty handy. You can also tilt the teeth or pinch them at the end. Let's reset some settings here so you can see this more easily. The tilt and the pinch at the end. I make the shape a bit bigger again. You can also curve the teeth here. And many gears in real life have are created with two separate segments and often look like that. You can also still curve between this edge here and control more settings about the pinch. For example, extruding it to the outside or pinching it to the center. You can also round up those edges to make them less sharp, or invert the extrusion, which looks a bit fancy. The rounding can also be applied to this edge going from the teeth to the root here. And there are different root styles. Right now it's on flat, but you can also have it be rounded just like the overall shape. If you want to create some inner rings, you can go to this section and just drag the sliders here. Maybe you don't want them to be a circle, then you can also toggle this checkbox and make them angular to fit the outside of the shape. Right now we only created a path, but you can also convert this to a shape layer. Let's give it some color. And all those updates will still be applicable to the live shape. There's another panel called Circle Arranger, and you can simply select a layer, go to Element Options, and let the panel create a bunch of copies for you. Now, if you click Arrange Circular, it will create a circle at the center of the document. You can again control the radius and something like the range also, if you don't want a whole circle. And you'll see now why this is helpful in combination with the gear creator panel, because if you have a gear like this and a shape like that, which is maybe already rotated, you can just lock this layer in place so it will keep this original position and then create a bunch of copies. and it will create those copies and rotate them perfectly. Let's increase this to 360 again, and it will cover the whole gear shape. Of course, you can increase or decrease as you like. Here are a few more examples of what you can do with the plugin. All right, this has been Clockwork. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time.